Some of the least traveled countries in Europe. On one hand, they're home to IKEA and Volvo and ABBA, Bjorn Borg and Carlsberg. And on the other hand, it's the land of the midnight sun and the Vikings. Scandinavia is Europe's best kept secret.
Scandinavia มี Norway, Finland และ Iceland ค่ะแต่ฉันจะเที่ยวแค่2ประเทศทางใต้สุดคือสวีเดนและเดนมาร์กการเดินทางเริ่มต้นที่โคเปนเฮเกนฉันนั่งรถไฟจากที่นั่นค่ะไปเที่ยวเทศกาลไวกิ้งที่ออฮุสก่อนข้ามไปสวีเดนขึ้นเหนือเลียบคาบสมุทรคาเลนจากนั้นแฉลบซ้ายเข้าสตอกโฮล์มหลังจากไปดูทะเลบอลติกแล้วก็กลับมาที่เมืองหลวงเพื่อฉลองกับชาวเกย์และอับบ้าค่ะเป็นประเทศเล็กสุดในสแกนดิเนเวียมีโคเปนเฮเกนเป็นเมืองหลวงมาตั้งแต่ต้นศตวรรษที่15ค่ะมีเขตเมืองเก่าสวยๆที่ห้ามรถผ่านด้วยเมืองนี้มีประชากร2ล้านคนหรือ1ใน4ของชาวเดนมาร์กทั้งหมดที่นี่สะดวกมากค่ะอาชญากรรมน้อยทุกคนพูดภาษาอังกฤษได้และการเดินทางก็เยี่ยมเลยค่ะ
It's a cozy little place ain't it This is the Dan Hostel in Copenhagen It's very centrally located It has over 1000 beds in it Now here's the thing Denmark is a very expensive place to travel. Accommodation, whoa, but let me tell you, they have a great network of hostels and there is some hope for those with a small budget, which is me.
Dan Hostel คิดราคา25ดอลลาร์ต่อเตียงค่ะโดย1ห้องอาจมี4ถึง10เตียงก็ได้
If you don't mind sharing, I have a 6-person room that you can have the four of you together. I don't know.
I snore really, really loudly. I snore like this. Hey, wait a second. You're in our room.
Sorry, what are you guys doing?
They said that there would be four of us in here. Did they say you had it to yourselves?
Yeah, they said it was going to be six guys in here.
Maybe there was.
They said this was a male dorm.
I got lucky. There's one city bike left. Now here's the thing. This is a great city to bike around, but it costs $18 to rent a bike. However, the city provides free bikes for 20 kroner coin. That you get back at the end of the day. You cannot beat that. It even comes with a map.
จักรยานหลวงเป็นแผนควบคุมการจราจรค่ะทุกฤดูร้อนเขาจะจัดจักรยานไว้ให้กว่า 2,000 คันช่วงต้นทศวรรษที่1960รถล้นเมืองรถติดมหาศาลแต่ทุกวันนี้มีคนขับรถไปทำงานแค่1ใน4คนและมีคนใช้จักรยานกว่า 600,000 คน
There she is The Little Mermaid inspired by The Fairy Tale by Hans Christian Andersen clearly very popular with the tourists The locals apparently aren't so fond of her She's been decapitated a couple of times bombed pushed over in the water Now I don't know what she did to them but I'm quite pleased to see her The tale of the Little Mermaid goes something like thisA mermaid fell in love with a prince. In order for them to be together, she had to become human. So she went to see a witch. Now, the witch made a very harsh deal. Number one, she had to sacrifice her voice, so she was mute. Number two, when she walked on her new feet, it would feel like she was walking on knives. And number three, if the prince fell in love with another, she would have to return to the ocean where she would die. And that's how the story ends. She dies. I think Hans Christian Andersen may have had some issues.
ศตวรรษที่19เป็นยุคทองทางวรรณกรรมของเดนมาร์กฮันส์คริสเตียนแอนเดอร์สันก็เป็นนักเขียนที่คนรักที่สุดและอยู่โคเปนเฮเกนกับตลอดชีวิตค่ะ
Here he is the man Hans Christian Andersen and although he did struggle for a long time and he was quite poor he was finally published in 1829 became famous in Denmark became famous throughout the world he lived happily ever after even though he never married and died at the ripe old age of 70It's a good fairy tale in itself.
I reckon if you're going to come to Sweden and Denmark, one thing you've got to bring is a pair of sunglasses, because it stays light until 10:30 at night, and then the sun gets up at 2:30 in the morning. So I reckon you've got to wear your sunglasses nearly 24 hours a day. But if you come in winter, you've got to bring a torch or a flashlight because it's hardly light at all.
And bring lots of money because it's very expensive.
No, it's very expensive, very expensive.
Station in Copenhagen, and I'm headed to the world's largest Viking festival, or at least one of the world's largest Viking festivals. Hello.
Hello.
Aarhus. Is that right? Return, please.
Return, please.
Yeah. How much is that?
That would be
594. That is not cheap. That's about $100. Luggage, if not for me. Train travel here is great. It's efficient, it's on time, but I didn't realize it could be so crowded, so I would suggest booking, reserving a seat for yourself. Otherwise, like me, you're in the back with the bikes and the prams and the luggage. 3.5 hours, no problem.
Aarhus อยู่ทางตะวันตกเฉียงเหนือของโคเปนเฮเกนค่ะบนคาบสมุทรเดนมาร์กโคเปนเฮเกนเป็นเกาะนะคะรถไฟต้องลอดอุโมงค์ใต้ทะเล8ไมล์ข้ามสะพานแล้วเลี้ยวขึ้นเหนือเลียบหาดไปค่ะ
But on the streets you see a lot of beautiful women and the amazing thing about that is that they like to show their breasts and they like to ride bicycles with short skirts and show their breasts it's a treat to men you know people like me from Hong Kong never see that in Hong Kong so it's a great place to visit
yes. for men only
yeah for men
ที่สุดอันดับ2ของเดนมาร์กเกิดขึ้นในศตวรรษที่10ค่ะโดยพวกไวกิ้งเพราะมีทำเลดีทางยุทธศาสตร์บนคาบสมุทรจัตแลนด์ก็ตั้งชื่อเมืองว่าออฮุสแปลว่าเมืองริมน้ำค่ะเทศกาลไวกิ้งมอสการ์จัดทุกปีออกนอกเมืองเลียบชายหาดไป15นาทีค่ะ
Vikings date back to around 600 AD, and they came from what we now know as Sweden, Denmark, and Norway. Now, they were seafaring warriors, but for many, they were little more than pirates.
นักประวัติศาสตร์บอกว่ายุคไวกิ้งมีอยู่ประมาณ400ปีค่ะจนเกิดสงครามที่เฮสติงเมื่อปี1066แต่ไวกิ้งเป็นทั้งช่างฝีมือพ่อค้าและนักสำรวจที่ยึดมั่นในวัฒนธรรมนอร์ดิกที่ยังไม่จางหาย
For this man named Per He's not just a man He's a Viking He's a jarl of a small authentic Viking village in Sweden Oh Viking hugs Viking hugs
No
Is this I'd like a Viking hug
Yeah it's always great to have a Viking
hug It seems warm and fuzzy Good morning Per
Good morning
How are you today
A bit tired since yesterday but
yeah.
it's alright
You have to get your energy together for
the fights
for the fight this afternoon
yeah.
And it's huge How many people will fight today
We are going to be two battle lines with approximately around 150 person on each side so it's going to be a battle with 300 warriors
300 warriors Now what side are you a part of
I'm part of the Fenris.
And who's that?
Fenris is the giant wolf that could eat all of the world in one bite.
Of course.
Yes, and we are going to eat the ravens.
Is everyone here a Viking, or what makes somebody a Viking?
You have to have it in your blood. It's something blood. That you feel from far, far behind. You can hear like the call from the wilderness. You
okay.
are a Viking. I'm a professional Viking. This is my occupation, being a Viking.
Could I be a Viking?
Yeah, if you don't want to walk around like a tourist, I can dress you as a Viking. So you can become a Viking and you can feel the Viking vibes.
I'd like to feel the Viking vibes.
Yeah. Wolfgang!
Yeah!
Vesson!
Yeah!
Vinden!
Yeah!
Bricky!
Yeah!
Eric!
Yeah!
Scar!
Yeah!
Per!
Oilet!
This is my Viking stance. This is my Viking outfit. What do you think?
Looks good.
So does this say anything about me, what I'm wearing?
I thought that maybe you should go and be a bit plain so you don't outtake all the rest of the Vikings over
here. I don't want to outtake a Viking because I don't want to get into a Viking girl fight because it could get ugly.
I'm a
fighter. I come here to fight with warriors from all over the world. But whether you come here to fight or you come here to watch, you wouldn't miss Mosgaard for anything in the world because of the intensity of partying with the Vikings for a whole week and living and drinking like they did back in the 800s in the Viking age. It's not to be missed.
There are some rules, however. You can't actually impale anybody. You're supposed to kind of hit them rather lightly, and then they're considered dead, and they fall to the ground. Oh, there's Perrin.